Two Fort is the Walmart of TF2.
They say that there's no better place to spend a good 8 hours of your day, but have you ever wondered why?
No.
Throughout its lifespan, this map has achieved an infamous status for several reasons. We're just gonna ignore those for now. But what about the map's underbelly? The stuff you only see once in a few days.
To answer this, we've set out to investigate the people of Two Fort.
Wait. Did you see that? All right.
This film was brought to you by Opera GX, the world's most browser. Here at the production office, we care about three things: efficiency and quality. So when it comes to how our editors operate,
they need the best of the best. But don't take it from me, take it from them. Hello, I'm the editor. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever pressed Control T and immediately wished you didn't? If you're like me, you have way too many tabs open at one time, and with Opera GX's built-in RAM and CPU limiters,
and the network limiter, of course,
you can keep these tabs open while doing other things. Over here on the side, we have the... Oh, the name just made sense. That's why they call it that. Anyway, over here is the sidebar, a convenient place for all of your streaming services, thanks to the GX player, streamer services,
gaming,
messengers, some of which I can't even pronounce.
What's up?
How was I supposed to figure that out? Don't have a computer? Get it on your phone. Don't like the color scheme? Hope you brought your color theory textbook. Don't like the background image? You can change that too. I like setting it to this vibrant green because with a little studio magic, I can make this place come to life. Oh, crap. It sounds expensive, huh? Well, it is. Just kidding, it's free. Link is in the description. Download today and try it for yourself. Thanks, Opera GX, for sponsoring this video.
We now return to your regularly scheduled program.
As part of the investigation, I was given two tasks: to document the behavior of the residents, and more importantly, to track someone down. And I succeeded. But let's rewind a little bit. First, I have to tell you what got me here in the first place.
So, there's this thing called the Q button, and kind of just click it and wait.
I had arrived, and it wasn't long before I met the locals.
The sandwich killed me.
This is how you make friends. Just do this. I was having a good time watching this guy throw piss at people and then laugh at them when I remembered that I still had a job to do. In that non-disclosure agreement I signed, it said I needed to find someone who captured the energy and essence of Two Fort and to not tell anyone about it. For now, I was going to take things one at a time. But the question is, where do I start? We're all familiar with the two ends of the player base, the people who want to kill you and the people who don't, but what about the outliers? As part of our psychological study to understand the thought process behind this person's decision, we interviewed a doctologist, and he told us to go to our nearest hospital and ask for a lobotomy. In this next case, the suspect was acting normal, and everything seemed to be fine. Until it dawned.
Kill me. Take the shot. Kill me. Kill me. Kill me. Kill me.
The network has asked that we tone back the dark themes for the sake of our ratings. So, look at this funny guy.
Oh.
Oh.
It's adorable. Okay.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Looking at violence again, are we? One sec.
Put up the warning thing so we don't get yelled at.
Warning. The following footage is not of real people. It's all in your head. All graphic material is purely for educational purposes.
Coca-Cola gloves. I just wanted to take my time.
What will happen to the medic? Find out next time. Now, this whole journalism thing may look like nothing but fun, right? Well, the truth is, during my studies, my life was threatened.
Lettuce, man.
New map.
At this point, processes inside the body were already getting to work. My nervous system was getting nervous. My amygdala, the part of the brain responsible for the fight or flight response, was... Well, it was gone. The doctor totally botched the lobotomy. But the one thing that was still functioning properly was my respectfully ignore things gene. Nah, I'm kidding. No, it wasn't.
Bye!
Bye-bye.
Math is shit. I'm not gonna get
a kid. Let's talk a little bit about something called luck, which apparently these guys just don't seem to have any of. Here we see Gabriel, an unfortunate individual who was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It seems this admittedly impressive play has sparked some cockiness. I'm sure things will work out just fine for him.
Nice shot! Sentry right up ahead! I told you.
And of course, every so often you'll get someone who's unlucky.
This will work.
Fuck! I didn't even know!
And now, for our regularly scheduled intermission.
Parched on the battlefield? Forget non-alcoholic energy drinks and say hello to non-alcoholic soda.
It is a very drink.
Drink responsibly.
Alongside the release of the game in 2007, players got the perfect mess that is in-game voice chat.
Yo, does anyone here have a mic?
No, I don't, sorry.
Comedy clubs like Bed Bath & Beyond were no longer seeing any business because people could now just boot up a game of Two Fort and listen to the nonsensical drivel of their teammates if they wanted a good laugh.
You don't need to tell the entire chat of what size your balls are and explain how
to plants for makes me sneeze.
Doug, what the fuck is your profile pic? Your dad?
Wait, no fucking way. Yes.
No, you're pulling my leg.
I mean, yes, the man in the picture is extremely attractive. That's an objective fact.
How am I dominating seven people?
And I don't know if you guys know this, but Two Fort is quite the hotspot for tourism. Australian tourism, to be specific, every so often you'll see this. One of the things that stuck with me the most was this fellow. A disrespectful attitude, a lack of self-awareness, and zero common decency. This guy had it all. And it nearly sent me over the edge. But wanting to be the bigger person, I did my best to not let it get to me. Just about all the other snipers I met showed more than a kindergarten level of consideration for others, thankfully.
I love you, piss man.
And to be honest with you, they're just plain fun to watch. Almost like bird watching, but the birds are big and have guns.
Look at this. Come on, you got this. He's got this, he's got this.
Let's observe. Shoot me in the head.
Come on, Micron 111. You got this. Breathe. Yes! Let him go.
Hit reg is reg.
Go, go, go!
Hold on, I'm observing someone.
One thing I learned is that if you spend enough time here, you're bound to run into some familiar faces. The large population of tourists makes a lot more sense when you not only take into account the scenery. But also the... well, let's just call them characters.
Holy crap, it's Ronald McDonald. Oh, Luigi?
Vaccinator.
His name is Vaccinator Collector.
Fat Joe?
I'm gonna hit you with my hitting fist.
The fat angry stepdad.
Did you think I forgot?
No, stepdad! Come fat here. Angry stepdad! He's wearing lipstick.
But how did he get lipsticked? Well, the truth is, we'll probably never know. A lot of things here go unexplained. Who tripped and killed the medic?
Who put that suitcase there? I fucking tripped on it.
Take a look at this clip. I want you to see if you notice anything weird. Did you see it? Okay, because I didn't and there was nothing there.
Feeling dizzy there, pal?
I blacked out. All my belongings were gone, and the crooks even turned my cameraman into a camera. My despair was short-lived. I didn't know it yet, but I was about to come face-to-face with the person who I was looking for all this time. And his name was Twofort. At first glance, he was nothing special. At second glance, he was not special. But just wait until you see him get it. Just wait until you see him kill someone. He did this every single time, without fail. He was more dedicated than a person who is also very dedicated.
Wait, is he doing it? Where is Twofort? Oh my god! Twofort! What? He didn't do it. Why didn't he do it? Hello? Why didn't he do it?
Two Fort's behavior was so straightforward yet so compelling. More than anything, I wanted all the footage I could get. I would get him. All yours, pal. Oh, he's gonna do it. Stop looking at it. I can't have this anymore. You think he's still following me? Come on, Two Fort. I need to just watch the kill feed like all the time. I need to see him every time he... Like that. Just, what is he doing? Two Fort, be careful. Dude. Come on, Two Fort.
Oh, he got him!
Two Fort in his natural habitat. And just like that, Two Fort was gone. To cope with losing Two Fort so abruptly, I downloaded stock videos of sad people on the internet, and I gotta say, I felt a lot better afterwards. My job was done, and there was only one person to thank for that. You know, this whole journey really reminded me that you can't make a map like Two Fort anymore today, because the devs would just look at it and go, hey, wait, this is already a map, this is Two Fort. There's something special about a map with so many flaws, and I'll be honest, it was difficult getting myself to depart. They say you cry twice when you play Two Fort. Once when you arrive, and once when you leave. Fuck this map. And now that I had just finished crying, it was time for me to leave this place behind. Oh hey, look, I'm back.